Hello, welcome to my channel. I am a tutor. My videos are mostly for beginner PC users. In this video, I'll show you how to save all the drivers installed in Windows 11. Many users know that the maximum speed of the Windows is possible only after a clean installation. Immediately after a clean installation, the user often turns on Windows updates. After the update, the drivers will be installed on the system, partially or completely. Usually, the older the PC or laptop, the more drivers are installed during the update. The rest of the drivers will have to be installed by yourself. There are several ways to do this. You can download drivers from the official website of the laptop or your device. For example, graphics card. This is a good way, but it is quite long. If the computer or laptop is 3 years old or more, then the drivers on the official website will be the same as last time. Usually, manufacturers do not update drivers for old hardware. Based on this, I would not recommend using all kinds of programs that promise driver updates, except for official applications from hardware manufacturers. Usually, such programs just work in the tray and, from time to time, offer you something to buy or install. A good way to install drivers is to install the drivers that work on your system now, before reinstalling Windows. To use the method, you need to create a backup copy of the drivers. In this video, we will see how to do it in Windows 11. It works in Windows 10 too. To create a backup copy of the drivers, we use the built-in tools of Windows. Let's use the DISM command line tool. DISM is a special tool for preparing Windows images. You can work with the DISM tool through the command line. Beginners usually don't like to work with the command line, but now you will see that backing up the drivers is not difficult. To create a backup, we will use the command. First, I need to create a folder for the drivers. Otherwise, an error will occur and the backup will not be created. The folder can be created on your computer's hard drive, or USB stick, or external hard drive. Most users have only drive C in Explorer. It is more correct to call it a partition. I will also save the backup to the main system partition. If you want a backup to a different partition, be sure to change the letter in the path. In this case, specify in the command the folder name that you came up with. I open partition C and create a folder in the usual way. I will name it as it is written in my path. Now I open the command line. To do this, I click on the start button and type cmd. The label has appeared. To run cmd as administrator, click here. Confirm here. The command line is open. I enter a command. You can copy and paste it from the description if you like. Space, slash. Here I enter the path and the name of my folder in quotes. The command has been entered. To run it, press enter. The backup process has begun. It usually takes from a few seconds to several minutes. That's it. The backup has been created. Let's see what's in the folder. Inside are separate folders with drivers for each device. The size of my folder is approximately 1 gigabyte. This is the average size. Your folder can be either larger or smaller. This laptop has 2 graphics cards, and accordingly for each separate driver. Drivers for discrete graphics cards are usually larger than other drivers in terms of disk space. If the computer is very budget, with integrated graphics, then the folder size can be 100 megabytes, and even less. If the laptop is expensive and new, the driver package can be several gigabytes. When the user has installed Windows, he can immediately start installing drivers. I copied the folder with the drivers to the flash drive. I connect it. Open Device Manager. Right-click on the Start button and select it. Here you can see that several drivers are not installed. They are marked with similar icons. To install this driver, right-click on it. I choose Update Driver. In the window that opens, select the bottom item, Browse My Computer for Drivers. Here you need to specify the path to the folder with the drivers on the flash drive. It is not necessary to specify a separate folder with the driver. It is enough to specify the shared folder in which all the drivers are located. I press Driver Search. The driver is being installed. The first driver is ready. Now I do the same for the rest of the uninstalled drivers. We can back up drivers in PowerShell. This time I will create a folder on the desktop. I'll name the folder the same. I'll copy the command in the video description. I will not highlight the path. Right-click on the Start button. I choose Windows Terminal as administrator. In the Windows Terminal, you can open all consoles. PowerShell, Command Prompt, Azure. To insert a command, simply right-click here. In order not to make mistakes in the path, you can use the Windows 11 menu item. Right-click on the desired folder. I choose Copy as a path. I return to the terminal. To paste the path, just right-click here. The command is ready. I press Enter. We are waiting for the completion of the process. We check the folder. That's it. The driver backup has been successfully created. Do you want to know another easy way to install Windows 11 drivers? Support this video with your wonderful likes. Thanks for watching my videos. If the videos are helpful, please like them. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next video. Perhaps the video will be useful to your friends. Please share with them. I wish health to all viewers. It was Tutor. See you soon.